If you want to insert a Divi module inside the Divi module, we can use a hook for that called do short code. So this will work not only in Divi, but in all kinds of themes and WordPress. So yeah, what we will need for this video is a child theme as a and a functions.php and a snippet of code. So this will not require any technical skills. By the way, this code is originally from Divi Soup. So I will just explain with you guys what's the meaning of that code. And I will also have an article version in case I miss some information in here. So before we jump into the custom thing, we need to make sure that we have a child theme. So if you are unfamiliar with the child theme, I'm gonna put the link description below for the related tutorial about the child theme, so feel free to check that out. So yeah, so as you can see in here, the child theme is already activated because we will be putting the code into our functions.php, okay? So first is I'm gonna add a new page in here. And let's call this a custom tab, okay? Custom tab. And then I'm gonna click the use Divi builder, okay? To enable the Divi builder. And then we will add a new module. And I'm gonna use a tab module, okay? Tab module. You can also use other module actually, like accordion or toggle. Because our goal in here is we want to insert a module inside a parent module. So in this example, I'm going to insert a module or a design inside the tab module. So let me just show with you later on that. So let's say this one is Monday. All right, so after this one, I'm gonna add another modules and let's try to come up with a four columns module. And then I'm gonna add probably a form or yeah, let's try to add a custom icon or blurb. So that one. And yeah, I think like that. And let's just use an image. So by the way, guys, this is just a sample design. You can always use whatever design you want. So red, and let's duplicate this one. Okay, and I'll just set this with a centered, so I want it to be centered. Okay, and let's duplicate the other modules in here. Okay, and I can also come up with like one column, and then let's add some sort of like, or yeah, let's just put something like this. I don't want to be really, for now, I don't want to be really picky with the design. You can always design, you guys really know what's the better design you want. For example, we're already, you are contented. I'll just pretend that you are contented with this kind of layout and you want this layout to be inside the Divi tab. By default, it's not applicable. So we need to do a custom thing and we need to use a filter in order to insert this module or this design inside to the parent module. And that can be only achieved if we use do short code. First, once you're already contented with your layout, you can then click the save style, and then I'm gonna call this sample, and click the save. Okay, save, and then we will go to the appearance theme editor, and then go to the functions.php. Wait, my internet connection is a bit slow, so. Themes, theme editor, and then functions.php, and then we put this code. Oops, sorry. So we put this code. And I will explain with you what's the meaning of this hook. By the way, this hook is originally from Divi Soup, and I'll just try to explain with you what it's meaning and what are the elements that you can probably change as well if you want to for branding or aesthetic purposes. So, okay, so why do we need this one? So first is we need to use the add short code in order for us to create a short code, okay? And the short code can be helpful for you to insert a specific layout or to call a specific layout, not just for the Divi theme, but for the entire WordPress website. And so in order for us to create a do short code hook, we need to come up with a function. So by default, it is like functions and then the name of the short code. So you can use whatever name you want. And then the argument, okay? And this one as well can be changed, okay? This one can be changed and this one can be changed, but you just need to follow the syntax. Functions and then your preferred name for the functions and then the argument, okay? Now let's proceed to the other text. Okay, so or the other syntax. So the other syntax is extract. Okay, so we want to extract the short code attributes with the array of with an array. Okay, so when it says array, you can also add different arrays, by the way. But for now, this one is only we are only extracting the ID of like the Divi library because we just as you remember in here, we save the layout, right? So we are trying to just kind of like extracting the Divi ID in here. And if you want to add more array, because array can be multiple, if you prefer to have more extraction, you can also come up with like something like this. And then what's like the name of the attributes and its corresponding value. But let me just replace that, revert it back to original, because we are just extracting a one ID, okay? And we put asterisk in here because we only extract the ID. We are not extracting a specific, like we are trying to be dynamic as possible. So we're only extracting the ID in general in order for us to call it. And now let's jump into the other one, which is return do short code. What will happen is we want to return a value. And we use do short code in here because this one, okay, in order for us to call this layout, we need to use the reserve short code from Divi. So this is the syntax of a short code, okay, this one, okay. And you need to put like an ID on it, like the ID number to be specific. But since we want it to be dynamic as possible, we only concatenate the like the ID variable, and this one will be kind of this one, like this one is connected to each other. So in order this to work out, we need to extract it. So that's the reason why we come up with this code first. And then we're trying to call this short code. The last part will be, we want to come up with a short code name in order for WordPress to know when this code or when this return will be called. I hope that makes sense. So show library item is the name of the short code. You can use whatever you want. By the way, this one is like a short form of show library item, something like that. But since we want to be like, I mean, we are not just calling a specific short code. We want to have a dynamic result. That's why we are extracting this and just come up with like that kind of stuff like that. So, yeah, let me just go back. To add short code, show library item, it depends on your name. You can use whatever name you want. And then this one should be similar to the functions that you created, okay? So that's the combination of echoing or inserting a layout, a Divi layout, using a short code, okay? So if we update this one and let's say I want this to be called inside the tab modules, what we can do is just click this and go to the tab, and then we will use the short code that we have. It's called show library short code. Okay, and then we put it there, and then I want to specify the ID because I want to specify the ID, and the ID for that is 24594. I put it there and save, and then save and exit that one, and then let's try to view. So as you can see here, this module that, I mean the custom design that we created, I already removed it underneath the tab, and we inserted the short code, and as you can see here, it is already nested inside the tab modules. Now I'm gonna try to use other short code for the Tuesday, and let's just look for some view layout in here from our Divi library, and let's draw some random designs in here. So I'm gonna use this limited offer. So again, click this one for the Monday, and then copy that short code there, and then we will change that short. We will paste that short code over there, and I'm gonna change that to the 5737 ID, and let's try it again, and let's save it. And then click the visual builder and click the Tuesday. So as you can see here, like we are just pretty nesting the layout from this, from the Divi library. You can also use like the .json file that is available on Divi or in Elegant Themes. I believe this is super useful, especially if you want to create a complex design, like Toggle, create a layout inside a Toggle, two columns layout as well for the slider. So this is absolutely applicable for that. And by the way, I have some few designs as well that I will create after this video, so make sure you check my website to see the styles that I created, and if you love those styles, then feel free to download it on my website.